everyone. This is Heidi from Hummingbird Yoga. Thank you for joining me today for some yoga. Hope everyone is doing well. This is my dog Daisy. And I'd like to guide you through an hour of yoga practice, beginning with taking a comfortable seated position, just noticing your body, setting a little intention, moving through some posture sequences, and ending with some relaxation. So, I like to set an intention. Of course, you can always set your own intention. Some little yogic thought to carry you through practice. Today's intention relates to Buddha and his teachings. He wandered the world wide, spoke to all the great sages of his time, looking for enlightenment, for peace, for happiness. And it wasn't until he just sat under this bodhi tree, that he was still. And he found that serenity and peace that he was looking for. So he discovered right in that moment of transformation why life is so troubling for so many people. He discovered what he calls the Four Noble Truths. Number one, life is difficult. Life is difficult because it is hard to bear. It's just a fact of life. You know, none of us are immune from that. We will all encounter difficulties throughout our lives. But the good news is, number two, is that we are able to overcome that. We know that we desire and we crave satisfaction in dissatisfying ways. Once we get to know that, then it's workable, it's doable, right? The possibility for enlightenment is there for everyone. So we just have to follow his simple path. It's an eightfolded path to enlightenment, and it's like spokes of a wheel, so we practice them simultaneously. It's not a linear path, and we're always practicing. We're never seeking or desiring or thirsting for anything. We're just present right here in this moment, just as it is. And you too can live that virtuous, fulfilled, liberated, impeccable life, as he called it. So, anyway, something to ponder here on your mat or in life. We'll begin with a little centering, lowering the eyes and dropping in. And noticing, observing where you are in this moment. Feel it in your body. Notice it in your breath. And what's happening in the mind? Just like the Buddha, allow the veil of illusion to drop from your eyes and see clearly things as they are, not as you think they are. Life is difficult. You too can be enlightened. To discover your Buddha nature takes practice, patience, and courage, a willingness to change, to transform. Too deep in your breath, inhale, fill your belly. Exhale, squeeze, empty. Inhale, come a little higher into your ribcage. Two-thirds of your lungs are filled. And let that go. And bringing the breath up a little bit higher into your heart center. And release. Finding your own dirgha breath, your three-part breath. Make it full and deep and diaphragmatic. Awaken right here. In this moment, just as it is. Know that life is changing all the time, a constant state of flux, insubstantial, ungraspable. Life, one of freedom and liberation, one of happiness, contentment. And then carefully letting go of that, turning to stillness, to this moment. Exhale, draw the chin to the chest and allow the head to hang heavy. Inhale, right ear toward the right shoulder, left shoulder drops. And there's a little space around your neck. Exhale, roll the head back to center. Carefully over to the other side, beginning to notice differences. Inhale, lift, roll the shoulders to the ears, back and down, open your heart. Find your compassion and loving kindness as you roll with your breath in one direction, and then carefully in the other direction. Inhale, arms reach up, stretch, elongate, come down the center line and into your sun breath. Inhale and exhale. Even breathing. Next time the arms come up, turn to your right. Give yourself a gentle twist here. Keep the spine long, the heart open. And then turn your head to look over that left shoulder. A couple of full deep breaths here. Shifting the eyes, just the eyes to the right. Exhale, unwind. Inhale, reach. Take it again to the other side, back into twist, this lovely posture. Feel your breath moving in and out, the rise and fall of your heart. And then take the head over to the right. Nice full breath here, shifting the eyes to the left. Inhale, unwind, inhale, rise up, exhale, float yourself gently down, ha. Let it go, let it be. And then inhale, a little lift from the crown. Come onto all fours, right into tabletop, wrists under shoulders, knees under hips. Square up the body, moving into little cat and cow from here. Inhale. Inhale, chin lifts, belly sinks. Open the heart. Pausing with your breath. Exhale, tuck and round into cat pose. Now again, move into your own rhythm at your own pace. Let that movement come from the pelvic area. Breath is still full. See everything along the way. And the next time you inhale, come right it back into tabletop. Find your balance here. Send the right toes out behind you. Curl the toes under. You're fully connected to the earth here. Then lift the left arm and open it out. Another big twist, a side body stretch. Perfect little pose. Full breath. Notice sensations building. And then releasing that. Try that on the other side. Left leg comes out behind. Take a moment. Work the hamstrings here. Dive inside and then open to your right. And then again, you'll notice differences in the sides. Where is your breath? Where is your mind? Stick with it. Consistency and persistency, those are your watchwords. Exhale, release, hand and knee. Separate your knees and drop all the way down into Garbhasana. Be still. And then inhale back into tabletop. Everything squared, curl both toes under. Lift that tailbone, hover here above the earth, looking down. Reaching up. Breathe from crown to tailbone. And then straighten on the exhale, moving right into Adho Mukha Svanasana, downward facing dog. Pedal your feet, shift your weight from one side to the other. And then come back into stillness. Nice full breath. Send the right toes up, little split. Breathe and balance. Life is difficult to bear, but you have the capacity to be enlightened, to be happy. It is your birthright. Step the right foot forward and come right into lunge pose. Nice full breath. Exhale, left knee drops. Inhale, rise up. Reach and arch, open. Life has lots of twists and turns. Exhale, bring your hands behind. But you're ready, you're brave and fearless. Exhale, let go, drop the head inside the knee. Arms overhead just as much as you can reach them overhead today. Exhale, releasing that. Curl the left toes under. Step yourself right back into downward facing dog. Perhaps a little deeper. Send the left leg up. Couple of breaths. And then come forward, back into lunge. Relax the shoulders. Reach out in opposite directions. Exhale, drop the knee. Inhale, lift. Awaken. Practice with compassion and courage and kindness. inhale, hands come behind. You'll squeeze as the heart opens. And gently bow forward. Nice full breaths. Carefully release on the exhale. Step yourself back into Adho Shvanasana. Take a full deep breath, maybe a cleansing breath. Ha. And then carefully walk yourself back to your toes and pull over into Uttanasana. Let go. Inhale, lift the crown, hands sweep behind. Give yourself some support here, a little flat back. And then rise up. Gentle little back bend. Exhale, inhale, back to center. Exhale, release your hands and stand ready to receive all the gifts, practice, the grace of this moment, exactly how it is. And we'll move into our first posture sequence. Nice and warmed up, ready. So standing at the back of your mat, if you're not already, feet planted into the earth. Nice full breath. On your next inhale, arms come forward at shoulder height. Exhale, bend the knees. Now you're taking your seat, Utkatasana. Shift your weight into your heels, lift the crown. Maybe opening the arms wide, or perhaps overhead for full expression of your posture. Breathe deeply. Feel it. Notice any resistance. Breathe into it. And awaken right here on this spot, just like the Buddha. Inhale, rise up, straighten. Next, exhale, send that right foot out in front of you. Find your balance, really reach through that left heel, sink down into Warrior One, Virabhadrasana Ekka. Maybe bending the elbows, fanning them out wide in these cactus arms. Take a few breaths here. Find that steady, comfortable pose. And then begin to pulse. Exhale, straighten the right leg. Inhale, come forward. Moving in a nice little rhythm. Next time you inhale forward, exhale, hands to your heart. Moving into prayer twist, left elbow outside the right knee. So if this is challenging, just drop right earth here. Drop to your forearms, whatever feels right for you in this moment. Perhaps using your blocks. Let Where can you soften? What can you release? Next, inhale, lift the crown, heel toe the feet in. Hands come to hips, a little flat back. Take a couple of breaths here in this beautiful shape. Then inhale, rise up. Restack, realign, reconnect. Spin the feet to the right. That right foot's at 90, left heel turns out, so the foot's in 45 degrees. Keep that left hand on the hip and the left shoulder back. Now look down at those right toes. Slide the fingers. Drop your head. Take a couple of breaths here. Then inhale up through the center line. Find your balance, arms open wide, preparing for a full triangle pose, Trikonasana. Inhale, lift, exhale, reach all the way out to your very edge. And the right hand drops and the left arm lifts. That hand is somewhere along the right leg. Not too far, no rounding here. Lift up and back like you're leaning against a wall. Palm facing out so you can really engage those abdominal muscles. Take a few breaths. Find your strength. Courage. It's hard to bear. Dukkha. Exhale. Release the left hand. Lift the right. A little twist here, rotated triangle, Hariddha Trikonasana. Exhale, carefully take that down, step back into downward facing dog. Adho Mukha Svanasana. And then walk your hands back to your toes. Pouring over, letting go. And then from here, bring the hands behind into your little flat back. Inhale, carefully rise up. Exhale, drop back. Open the heart. Inhale, come back to center. And exhale, be still. Pressing into the earth. Reaching from the crown, reconnecting to this moment. No clinging or attachments, no desiring for things to be other than what they are. That's the path to enlightenment. That's the secret to happiness. And then we'll move right back into the other side. Arms come forward. Inhale. Exhale. Bend those knees. Lift from the heart. You might even want to roll onto the toes this time, lifting the heels. Could be a little wiggly wobbly. Just notice. Play around with it. Arms can open wide, keep them long and straight, maybe overhead. Sink in a little deeper. In Utkatasana, take your seat right here on this spot and awaken. There'll be lots of detours. Roadblocks, but you remain steady. Exhale, release. Inhale, rise up. Nice full breath. In mountain pose, Tadasana. Then the left foot comes forward. breath, your strength, and your softness. Exhale, fan out the elbows. There'll be mountains, valleys, plateaus, and deserts. Be ready to change. Exhale, straighten. Inhale, dive in. You too can transform yourself, discover your Buddha nature, which is always there. There's no searching for happiness. Happiness is right here where you are. Exhale, hands come to heart center. Nice full breath. Give yourself a twist to the left this time. And again, you can modify as needed. Drop the knee to the ground. Or just remain comfortable in this rather awkward pose. Listen to your breath. And then exhale, unwind. Walk yourself around to the right. Your back in this wide angle. Prasarita, Padottanasana, dive in. Maybe a little deeper, more relaxed, more comfortable. Listen to your breath. Explore and discover it's always there. It is your birthright. Inhale, crown lifts, hands walk forward. Heel toe the feet in a tap for balance. Hands to your hips, come right back into flat back. Look within. Wisdom is the antidote to suffering. Inhale, come up to center. Full deep breath. And then spin your feet to the left. Really turn that right heel out. Square up the body. Right hand still on the hip. Slide the left fingers down the leg. Pull the right shoulder back and breathe. A little balance here. Inhale, rise up. And then open the arms wide. Finding Trikonasana. On this side, reach out with the left fingers. Take it to your very edge. And nearly rotate the arms. Again, left palm facing out. Really engage the body here. Connecting heaven and earth. Wisdom and compassion. Following Buddha's path to enlightenment. An impeccable life. And then exhale, take that right hand down and the left arm up. You can adjust your feet if you'd like, bringing that back foot in just a tad, maybe using a block here in Parivritta Trikonasana. Soften, breathe, balance, maintain a balanced life. Keep that middle path. Exhale, release the left hand, step right back into downward facing dog. Little cleansing breath. Bend the knees, exhale. Either walk or hop forward. This time you're at the front of your mat. Core going over into Uttanasana. Let go. Be still. Inhale, lift the crown. Hands come behind. Little support here in your flat back. Inhale, rise up. Tiny back bend. Inhale, come back to center. And exhale, you're back in your mountain pose, receiving all the gifts of practice. Integrate them into your body, into your life. Beautiful. And then move into another posture sequence. So again, you're at the front of your mat, grounding yourself. Spread those toes wide. Feel the texture of the earth beneath you. Inhale, arms reach out, broaden, extend, radiate. Your arms come all the way up in Uttita Tadasana, extended mountain. Pressing down, reaching up, just like the mountain. Steady, comfortable. Full breath. Next, exhale, bend the knees once again. This time, hands together down the center line, back into a little squat, and another prayer twist. Shoulders relax away from the ears. Move to your right, left elbow outside the right knee. And breathe. Notice your breath. Where can you soften? Exhale, unwind. Inhale, rise up all the way. And then step that left foot out. Now bring those heels in toward each other. Drop the tailbone and find your goddess pose, Devyasana. Really tuck that tailbone. Into a little flow here. Inhale, open the arms wide, fingertips touch ever so lightly. Exhale, again, reach out with the arms, make a beautiful circle here back to your heart, always coming back to your heart. Moving into this little flow, little vinyasa. What's happening here? Make any little adjustments. Grow comfortable. The next time you exhale, fan out the elbows and find full expression of Devyasana. Breathe into it. Relax. Lift the corners of your mouth. Realized under that body tree. Exhale, hands to heart center. Spin the feet back to the right. Align your spine. Nice full breath. And then the arms open wide once again. Now you're in warrior two, Virabhadrasana Dvi. Finding even breathing into the rib cage. You're steady on that path. Ready to transform, ready to change, to awaken. And the left hip comes forward. By that left arm, reach up, maybe widening your stance here in Warrior One, Virabhadrasana Ekka. Powerful pose. Exhale, arms come. from behind once again, just like we did in the warm-up. Little squeeze, heart opens, and now bowing forward. Show your devotion. Let go. Be still. Exhale, release your hands. And then step that left foot up to meet the right. Pour over into Uttanasana. Really let go of desire, clinging attachments. Inhale, lift the crown. Hands come behind. Give yourself again a little flat back. Full deep breath here. Rise up. Inhale and exhale, draw back. Inhale back to center. And then gently release. Feel about it. Push nothing away. And accept life just as it is. We will all face adversities, challenges. How do you handle it? How do you respond? And then again, planting the feet firmly in the earth. Inhale, arms come out at shoulder height. Full deep breath here. Expand, expand a little more. And take those arms overhead. Pinkies face each other. Listen to your breath. Ujjayi. Like the sound of the ocean as it rolls in and out. And then hands together, back down the center line. Come into your squat. Inhale, lift the crown. Exhale, over to your right once again. You can stay here in this beautiful prayer twist, or perhaps you want a little more challenge. Arms extend in opposite directions. A little deeper squeeze in the torso. A little harder to breathe. Exhale, unwind. Inhale, rise up. And then come right back down. Carefully taking it to the other side. And again, maybe the arms want to open in opposite directions. Not for everyone. Remember to listen to your body. It changes from moment to moment. From breath to breath. Exhale, unwind. Inhale, rise up. And exhale, right back to your heart. Be still. Next time you exhale, turn to your right this time. Heels move in toward each other just a tad. Knees bend. Spine is long. Full deep breath here. Grow comfortable in this shape. Then begin to move the arms out. Inhale, reach. Fingertips touch. And exhale, bend. Come back to your heart, creating that lovely circle. Never ending circle. Next time you exhale, fan out those elbows to find your Devyasana. Feel your human self and your divine self all at the same time. awaken. See things clearly as they are. Exhale, come back to your heart. Spin the feet to the left. Drop in. Focus. And sweep the dust from your eyes. Arms open wide. Turn your wrist to your gaze. Pass the left fingers this time. Back in Warrior Two. Virabhadrasana Dwi. Don't search for that enchanted place. The secret to enlightenment is right here. This moment, just as it is. And the right hip and the right arm, come forward, adjust your feet, find that perfect pose. Warrior One, steady, comfortable, on that path. All its roadblocks and challenges . Exhale release the hands and give yourself another little squeeze here . Wingtips touch, heart opens, drop forward. Surrender here. Let go of anything that's keeping you from happiness, contentment, from serenity and peace. Inhale, lift the crown. Exhale, hands come forward. Step that right foot up to meet the left. And let yourself go. Inhale, flat back, press the hands behind, relax the shoulders, and then rise up. Inhale and exhale. Where are you now? Maybe a little tingling, vibration, energy coursing through you. To a little balance from here. So you can stay on your mat, you can step off to more solid ground, come to the wall if you'd like. Moving right into tree pose, Rikshasana. Find your balance before you begin. There's absolutely no hurry. Find a focal point. As you plant the left foot, right knee turns out. So many variations of this pose. Maybe just resting the heel on the ankle is nice. You can come to your calf, or perhaps you can grab the foot and bring it into the inner thigh. And take your time, hands at heart center. If you wobble out of it, just go right back in. Perhaps the arms want to extend, those branches reaching toward the sun. Listen to your breath. And carefully release, returning to center. A little cleansing breath. And the right foot. Now this side is different. Finding your deepest place, no hurry again. Feel it from the inside out. You can always take the tongue to the roof of the mouth, that sometimes helps. Lots of little tricks in Rikshasana. Deepest, most satisfying shape. Again, if you wobble out, just go right back in. Rooted in the earth, reaching toward the sun. And then come back to center. Carefully release. Full deep breath. Let it go. Be still. Right here on this spot. Hands extend long by your sides. And inhale, lift the fingers, come right back down the center line, little hinge movement forward in your back in Uttanasana. Inhale, crown lifts, little flat back. From here, walk or hop back into plank pose, flat as a board. Squeeze everything toward the midline. Full deep breaths. Strengthen this container. You can drop to your knees or come straight down onto your belly. Release the toes and slide those hands forward for a simple Sphinx pose. Shoulders roll back, heart presses forward. Breathe deeply. Lovely little back bend here. Look between the brows, Ajna. Your wisdom. See things as they are. Maybe lifting the toes, a little deeper stretch, not for everyone. Breathe into this perfect moment. And exhale, lower the legs. Lead with the heart, come forward. Send those arms out in front of you. Tuck the chin in this prone position. Take a nice full deep breath in this shape. Then begin to lift up. We'll move right into Navasana, boat pose. Toes reach out behind, arms overhead. Lots of variations of this pose. You can take those fingers out behind. Tucking the chin slightly so you've got that beautiful line from crown to tailbone. Maybe even taking the hands into a mudra here. And you're in your boat. On the sea of prana. Full, deep, diaphragmatic breaths. Exhale, gently down. Turn the cheek around and let go. Listen to your heartbeat. Next inhale, head turns back to center, hands under shoulders. Press yourself lovingly up and all the way back. This time, separate your knees. And come into a beautiful wide-legged child's pose. Soften with your breath. Be still. Inhale, hands walk back to center, knees together, sit in Vajrasana for a moment. And awaken. Buddha nature, just always there, sweep the feet to one side. Extend out through the legs. Find a simple dandasana. Press the palms into the earth. This is your foundation for all your seated postures. Curl those toes towards you. And breathe. Moving into Paschimottanasana. Arms reach out once again. Take your time. There's absolutely no hurry here. Gravity's doing all the work. Lifting from the heart. Keep that long spine never rounded. Each breath, a chance to deepen and release. Activate those legs. Maybe the arms come forward to either side of the legs. You can come to the shins if you'd like, keeping the shoulders soft away from the ears. Maybe even touching your toes, maintaining the integrity of this pose. Breathe deeply and fully. Slide the hands back, up the shins, right knee bends, foot comes into thigh, just like we did in tree pose for chasen. This time we'll move into Maha Mudra, the great seal. Keep the spine long, again, the heart open. Maybe just staying here, this is a beautiful pose, or perhaps you want to gently take it forward. Another little forward fold, a little hip opener. A gentle massage to your organs. Moving to your deepest, most satisfying posture. Maha Mudra, the great seal, sealing, marking your experience right here in this moment, just as it is, in this body with this breath, just as you are. Exhale, release, inhale, coming up to center. Take that right foot outside the left knee. Keep that long spine. Inhale. Now the left arm, so opposite arm and leg, wraps around. Nice little squeeze. Take it into a twist once again. Arm, that right arm across the horizon. Dropping the hand behind. Engage the body. Pass the right shoulder and breathe. Matsi Andrasana, a seated spinal twist. Exhale, begin to unwind, undo, uncurl, unfold. Coming back to center. Moving to your left, plant that left hand under the shoulder. A little variation of side plank, Vasisthana. Just try it. Hold on to that left hip, then lift it up. Left arm comes up. Press out through that left foot. Engage, breathe, balance. Life is difficult, hard to bear. But we all have the possibility to lead a happy, fulfilled, virtuous life. And then slowly drop it down. Right foot meets the left. Coming back into a brief dandasana. And then hinge forward. So again, maybe more relaxed, at ease. notice your breath and your mind. What can you let go of? Where can you soften? Yet you're actively engaged here. No Buddha's Four Noble Truths. Know the Eightfolded Path, right intention, right view, right speech, right action and livelihood, right effort, right meditation, mindfulness, and right concentration. And then carefully exhale, release that. Inhale, slide the hands up. This time bend the left knee. That foot comes into the opposite thigh. Square up your body. Relax. And find Maha Mudra once again. Take a few breaths before finding your deepest place. And then yield. Ease into it. Never forced. Listen to your breath. Stay connected to this moment. Exhale, release, slide yourself up on the inhale. Left foot comes outside the right knee. Take a nice full breath. And then right arm comes around that left leg, sweeping the left arm out across the horizon, dropping the hand gently back into your seated spinal twist, Matsi Andrasana. Squeeze out anything that doesn't serve you well, all the clinging and attachments, desires, wanting things to be other than how they are. Taking your seat here in this spot, sweep the dust from your eyes, and inhale, left arm comes across, and we'll take it to the other side, right hand plants, again, roll onto that right side, lift the hip, and breathe into Vasisthana, side plank, modify as needed. Stay with it. It's that stick-to-itiveness, that persistency and consistency that are your watchwords. And exhale, lower down, left foot meets the right. Move yourself forward on your mat. Give yourself a nice little squeeze here. And take the hands under the thighs. Toes reach out at knee height. Find a little balance in upward facing boat. Perhaps releasing the hands. Take a full breath, or maybe even straightening the legs in full expression of your posture. Next exhale, take it all the way down onto your spine. Send the arms overhead. Curl the toes toward you in Supta Tadasana, lying down mountain pose. actively engage here. There's a little space behind the spine. Breath is full. Then the right knee, use that foot as leverage to roll onto your left side. Extend out through the right leg. Stack everything, legs and feet and arms. Stay here or lift in this side boat posture. A little wiggly wobbly, just hang on. Engage, breathe, balance. And then carefully let that go. Take it back to your spine, back into Supta Tadasana. Feel your breath. And then the left knee bends, press into the earth, roll onto your right side. Again, everything is stacked. Moving back into side boat, reach up, balance, pivot it on that right hip. Notice if you're rolling back and just take it forward a tad. Breathe into it. And then lower, rolling onto your spine. Release the arms long by your sides. Nice, full breath. Moving into our final posture, taking the hands under the buttocks, palms face down, even partially tucking those arms, coming into fish pose, matsyasana. Again, really engage those legs, move the tailbone away from the crown, arch the spine, lift, press the heart forward, breathe. Open. Lift the corners of your mouth. And happiness, contentment is right here. This moment, exactly how it is. Slowly back to the earth. Release hands and feet. Moving into Shavasana, your final relaxation. Feel the weight of your bones sinking into the earth. Notice what's happening with your breath and your mind. And let it be still. In that stillness, you will awaken just for a moment. big breath. Arriving back here in this moment, exactly how it is. Little fingers and toes. Send the arms overhead to reach, stretch, and awaken all that is good. Bend the knees, wrap your arms around for one final hug. Thanking your body. Carefully roll the knees to one side and rest in your fetal position. And lovingly press yourself up into Sukhasana. I invite you to join me in the sound of Om, the sound that connects us to each other and to all that is. One final full deep breath. Practice, we lift up and say,